Question one, which of the following correctly reads the given number quantity? So this is 6,245,789. The answer is A. So I'll urge you to pause the video regularly to try to work it out before I answer. And the questions actually start on a very easy note, but as we progress, the difficulty increases. Question two, fill in the missing numbers in the sequence 2000, 19,000, 995. So you realize that it keeps decreasing by 5. This skip count backward, and the answer to this is A. Because if this decreases by 5, it becomes 19,990. If this decreases by 5, 19,980. Question 3. In a manufacturing plant, 3 different cutting machines can cut the following number of woods. So we have 532,678, 523,876, 532,789. And we have been told to order from the highest to the lowest number of wood they can cut. So this is the right order in which they should be arranged. 532,789 is the highest, followed by 532,678, followed by 523,876. So the answer is B. Question number 4. The Venn diagram shows the findings of a survey of students' favorite food for lunch. Use the information to answer question 4. So the question is, how many students like wache but not jollof? If but not jollof, then it means this is excluded. If the question was how many students like jollof, it means this will also be included. So we have Joseph, Kofi, Abner, and Mary. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the answer to this question is B. Question 5. The distance from the Earth to the Sun is approximately 93 million miles. Write this distance in the scientific notation. So to go about this, 9, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you're going to move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's where the decimal point will end. So the answer is B. Question 6. If the cost of a building project is estimated 876,543 Ghana cedis, round to the nearest 10,000. What's the rounded cost? So question 6. 10,000. So if it's 10,000 we are looking at, it's going to be focused on this. So our answer is going to be 880,000 Ghana cedis. So the answer is C. A student purchased 3 items at a school store. What's the total cost of the items rounded to the nearest Ghana cedis? So we are going to add everything. So 5.20, 8.50, 12.20. So this 0 here, you have 9 here, point. You have 5 here, you have 2 here. So you're going to end up with B, 26 Ghana cedis. Question 8. A carpenter needs to cut a piece of wood into 2 equal parts. If the wood is 3.678 meters long, to what decimal place should the carpenter measure and cut to ensure the 2 parts are close to equal as possible? So this is a place value question. So it doesn't need any calculation. So the 6 is to the nearest tenth, The 7 is to the nearest 100th. The 8 is to the nearest 1,000th. So the answer to this question is D. Question 9. The cost of an item is 10.75 Ghana cedis. How much should a customer pay for 100 of the items? So this question, you're supposed to multiply the 100, 10.75. So it will result in the movement of the decimal point to the last part. You're going to have 1,075 Ghana cedis. So the answer to this is D. Really like graph questions. The graph shows the world's largest cocoa bean producers in 2019. How much more cocoa did Ivory Coast and Ghana altogether produce than the four other countries? So what you're going to do is, thinking of the question, we have to do some subtraction. So we are going to have the number of cocoa being produced by Ghana and Ivory Coast against those produced by Ecuador, Belgium, Netherlands, and Malaysia. So we are going to add this and then subtract the total of this from this. And when you do your calculation right, your answer is going to be B. The next one, that's question 11. A carpenter bought 8.75 meters of wood to make shelves. If each shelf requires 1.25 meters of wood, how many shelves can the carpenter make? So we are going to share or divide into equal parts. It has to do with division. So 8.75 divided by 1.25. If you do your calculation right, you are going to end up with 7 shelves. That's C. Solve this equation. 2 exponent x equals 64. 2 exponent what number give you 64? And this is indices. It's 2 exponent 6. So your answer is D. Bacteria culture starts with 2 bacteria and doubles every hour. How many hours will it take for the culture to reach 32 bacteria? So it's doubling, and this doubling has to do with an exponent. So in the fifth hour means 2 exponent what number equals 32, and the answer is 5. So answer to this is H. We have E, F, G, H. So the answer is H. So the following fractions is equivalent to 75%. 75% is 75 over 100. And when you break it down, you're going to end up with 3 over 4. So the answer is C. Question 15. Compare and order the fractions 1 over 3, 2 over 5, 7 over 15. From the smallest to the largest. How do you order them? You order them by multiplying all of them by a particular number, say 100. And when you do that, the fraction which gives you the highest answer is the greatest. When you do that right, your answer to question 15 will be A. A recipe for a loaf of bread requires 3 or 4 cups of flour. If you want to make 4 loaves of bread for a party, but you have 2 cups of flour, how many more cups of flour do you need? So you need to approach this question in bits. So first of all, this is what the bread requires. 3 or 4. You want to make 4. So 1 equals 3 over 4. 4 equals what? So looking at it, we'll require more. If more, let's divide. So 3 over 4 multiplied by 4. So we have what? We need 3 cups of flour. But we are told that what? We have 2. So how many more cups do you need? So 3 minus 2 is 1. So answer to this question is A. Question 17. Mr. Abumpi bought 10,000 bricks for his house project. If the workers used 2 or 5 of the bricks during the first week, how many bricks are left? 2/5 of here means you're going to multiply. So 2/5 of the bricks, you're going to have 2/5 multiplied by 10,000. 5 here, 1, 5 here, 2. So 2,000 times 2, you're going to end up with B, 4,000. So the next question, the length of a rope is 1/3 feet. How many 1/3 feet long pieces can be cut from it? So for this question, you're going to convert this and that to proper fraction and work it out. So you are going to have 16/3 / 4/3. And then you are going to end up with 4. So your answer is B. The next question, the ratio of boys to girls in a certain junior high school, 3 class is 1:3. This means A, the boys are 3 times more than the girls. B, the girls are 3 times more than the boys. C, there are 3 more boys than girls in a class. D, there are 3 more girls than boys in a class. The answer to this question is B. The girls are 3 times more than the boys. So the next question, a recipe for making a drink calls for 2 cups of lemon juice and 6 cups of water to serve 8 people. If you want to serve 16 people instead, how much lemon juice and water will you need? So you need to double the cups of lemon and then cups of water if you double the people. So you're going to end up with 4 cups of lemon juice and 12 cups of water, which is A. If the car continues, okay, so let's read the heading. The distance in miles traveled by a car in hours is shown in the graph below. It says, if the car continues to travel at the same speed, how far will the car travel in 9.5 hours? So we can't read from the graph here, but we can do a simple ratio and proportion. If 1 hour is giving us 100 miles, then it means that we can equate 1 equals 100. If 1 equals 100, then 9.5, which is 9.5, equals... So we're expecting more. If we're expecting more, less should divide. So 9.5 over 1 multiplied by 100. We're going to end up with 950 miles. So the answer for this question is D. Assuming the car uses 1 liter of fuel every 8 miles, how much fuel will be needed to travel 100 miles since the cost of fuel is 14.25 per liter? Leave your answer to the nearest Ghana cedis. Now, for every liter, it's 8 miles, and you travel 100 miles. So 100 divided by 8, you're going to end up with 12.5. So if every 8 miles, you require 12.5 liters, then 12.5 multiplied by this amount will give you C, 178 Ghana cedis. So, the graph below shows a journey made by Anita from Accra to Shamma and Shamma to Breku. It says, use the graph to answer the questions that follow. So, he said, what speed did Anita travel in the first hour? So, in the first hour, she traveled, and you see that for this, you need to really zoom in to be able to get your answer. So, we zoom in more. So, this is 50. This 60, this 70, this 80, this 90, and that's 100. So she traveled 80 kilometers. It's 1 hour. So if it's 1 hour, 80 divided by 1, you're going to get 80 kilometers per hour. So the answer to this question is C, 80 kilometers per hour. Then it says, how long did Anita rest during the entire journey? So go back to the graph again. This was the resting period. So it was from the first hour to the second hour. So you're going to subtract 2 minus 1, which will give you 1 hour. The answer to this is B. And then it says, what was Anita's average speed from Sharma to Breku? Sharma to Breku, her average speed. So we go back to the graph. From Sharma to Breku. This is Sharma. And this is Breku. So you subtract the initial from the final. The final distance was 50. And then the initial was 200. So 50 minus 200, you end up with 150, which is the distance divided by the time, change in time. For the initial to be 4 and the final to be 6. So 150 or negative 150 over 2, which will give us 75 at the end. So we have B, 75 kilometers per hour. The next question we ask to simplify root 20. So root 20, you're going to end up with 4 times 5. This is going to give you 2 root 5. So answer is A. The shop sells biscuits in packs of 6. The table below shows the number of biscuits sold and their corresponding prices. Looking at the pattern, this is actually a mapping question.
So I have reframed this question in a mapping form. So 6 maps to 10, 12 maps to 18, 18 maps to 26, 24 maps to 34. So I'm using the method of difference. So we have the domain and we have the codomain. So the constant difference of the codomain over constant difference of domain. So this is the formula y equals ax plus b, where a is this formula. So I put the constant difference of the codomain, which is 8. So 8 here over 6. That's the constant difference for the domain. Then I had 4 over 3. So my a is 4 over 3. Now since my a is 4 over 3, the next thing is I just need to pick my x and y values. So I picked x, which is 6, and y, which is 10, for this one. So that's what I... Then I substituted. After substituting, this is what I had. So I went on to place for the x and y value, which is 6, and then 10. Then my a is 4 over 3. So after working everything out, I had my b to be 2. 3 here 1, 3 here 2. So I moved the 8 towards the side, so minus 8, I had 2. So afterwards, I now substituted it into this equation again. So this is my 2. So y equals 4 over 3x. So this is my formula for the question. Now, if I have this to be my formula, the question asks us that how many will we get for 30? So, and the 30 is for the domain. So I put that one here as 30. Then when I worked it, I had 42. So the answer to this question is 42.
So the question here says, the table below shows the number of chairs and the corresponding number of tables needed for a conference. It says, what is the rule that relates the number of tables to the number of chairs? We have 2, we have 10, we have 4, we have 20, we have 6, we have 30, we have 8, we have 40. You see that you keep multiplying by 5. So number of chairs equals number of tables times 5. So the answer to this is C. Then you have another graph here. The graph shows a relationship between the number of children and the corresponding number of sachet milk each family received. Use the graph to answer. So 1 went for 1, 2 went for 3, 3 went for 5, 4 went for 7, and so on. So let's see which one works. So let's look at 2n minus 1. So 2 multiplied by 1 is 2, minus 1 is 1. And let's pick another one in the middle, say 4 to 7. 2 multiplied by 4 is 8 minus 1. We are getting 7. So 4 matches to 7. So answer to this question is also A. how many sachets milk will 12 children receive? So 2 multiplied by 12 minus 1. You're going to end up with what, 23. So the answer is C. It says, look at the sails of the boat. How many lines of symmetry has a sail in the shape of the triangle labeled ABC? This is a scalene triangle. So it has no line of symmetry. So the answer is A. Question 28. What is the slope of the hill the car is climbing? Now, this is asking us for the gradient. So basically, it's y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. But we don't have y1, x2, and so on. But this is your y-axis, and this is your x-axis. So the y over your x. So y is 3, x is 12. So you're going to end up with 1 over 4. So answer to this question is A.
So your car is currently 3 years old and is worth 10,000 Ghana cedis. 2 years ago, it was worth 12,400 Ghana cedis. Assume the car's value depreciates linearly with time. Create an equation for the value of the car in terms of its age. Let's then represent the value of the car in Ghana cedis and T in terms of the age in years. So when you see this question, you know you are dealing with rates, and rates is spare time. So change in value over change in time. To find the equation representing the value of the car, we need to use the information given. So what you are asked is to find the information, to find the equation. Now to find the equation, we look at the time. That's the first year, the value of the car was 12,400. The third year, the value of the car was 10,000. So we just have to find the gradient. So change in value of the car over change in time. So we are going to have 10,000 divided by 12. 10,000 minus 12,400. Over 3 minus 10,000 minus 12,400 over 3 minus 2. So it means that the car depreciated. So we have negative 1,200. That's for the per year. That's for the gradient. And there's this equation of a line formula, which is y equals mx plus c. But in terms of this, we are going to use the variables that were given to us. So V equals MT plus B. When you do our substitution, we are going to have B equals 13,600. So we are just going to substitute back into this. So we have V equals minus 1,200 T plus 13,600. So with time, when you are given any different time, we can find the value of the car based on this.
Question 30. Jane and Mark went to a store to buy some pens and notebooks. They bought a total of 8 items and spent 20 cedis. Pens cost 3 cedis each and notebooks cost 4 cedis each. How many pens and notebooks did they buy? The shortest approach to go about this is to just multiply what you have in the options by the prices. So let's start with A. A says 4 pence, and 4 pence, 4 times 3 will give you 12, plus the notebooks, 4 times 4 will also give you 16. So you're getting 28. So the answer is A. Let's see why B is not right. 5 times 3 will be 15, plus 3 times 4 will be 12. It will give you 27. So A is actually correct. There's a long approach, but for the sake of the video, let's take the shortest approach. 31. Niyama visited the bank to invest some amount of money. Save the picture carefully and use the information. So answer 31. You have a principal here of 20,000, rate of 5%, a time of 2 years. Find the simple interest. Simple interest equals principal times rate times time, 100. Or if the rate is, you know, in percentage, so that's it. So when you multiply your 20,000 by your 5/100 and then your time, if you do your calculation right, you're going to end up with 2,000 Ghana cedis. That's your simple interest. Study the building plan carefully. So we are asked to find the perimeter of the warehouse. What is your length here and what is your breadth here? Assuming your length is 3,500 centimeters and your breadth is X centimeters. So with the formula for perimeter, your answer is C, 33. A balloon costs 2 Ghana cedis. If Jane bought 5 balloons for herself and then buy an additional X balloons for each of her 10 friends, what's the algebraic expression that can be used to express the total cost of the balloons? So the balloon costs 2 cedis. So if she just bought 5 balloons for herself, it would have been 2 multiplied by 5. So it would have just been like this, 2 multiplied by 5. She also bought X number of balloons for her 10 friends. If we knew the number of balloons she bought for her 10 friends, I also multiply the X by the 10. So since each balloon costs 2 cedis, we will just have to add, because this is what she bought for herself. And this number is what she bought for her 10 friends. So you have 2 bracket open, 5 plus 10x. The answer is A. To find the total distance around the knot, so X is 2. This is 2. This is 2. Y is 1.9. 1.9 here. And 1.9 down here. Then T is 2.1. Another 2.1 here. And this question is very interesting because you don't have to do a lot of calculation even. So what's going to happen is you can just stick the 0.1 here and then 0.1 here and then give it to the 0.9 here and the 0.9 here. So they all become 2. So at the end you have 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. And this is a 6-sided figure. So 2 multiplied by 6 is 12. This is question 34, is D. You are constructing a frame for the rectangular photo shown. You want the frame to be the same width all the way around and the total area of the frame and photo to be 315 square inches. What should the outer dimensions of the frame be? Now, when we say a frame, this is actually the frame. The golden part of what you have is the frame. So the dimension for that is S, S, and S. The dimensions for each part is S, S, and S. So first of all, you need to know that this is in centimeters. This is also in centimeters. But the total area of the frame is 315 square inches. So the total area is actually going to be the outer part. Now, there's this equation you can work with and then get your final answer. So you're going to have 11 plus 2s. Why 2s? The distance from this point to this point is 11 plus 2s. And the reason is the inner is 11 centimeters. So the outer frame, then the outer frame here is also S plus S. So 11 plus 2S, close the bracket, multiplied by, open another bracket, and you do same for this side as well. So it's also going to be 17 plus 2S equals the area in centimeter squared or square centimeters, but it's given in 315 square inches. Now to convert this to centimeter squared, you have to multiply by 6.16 to get, and when you do the multiplication, you're going to get 2032.18. So I recommend that you know how to convert from centimeter squared to square inches. And let's get it in line. So from then, when you work everything out right, your S will be 16.6, which is C, 17 centimeters. Question 36. Two sisters bought 10 tablets. One bought 4 tablets. Which of the following equations represent the number of tablets the other bought? You just need to subtract 4 from the total. So subtracting 4 from the total, this equation, which is A, is what That's right. Now, this question here is a linear equation question. You have different symbols with operations in between them. You call the rectangles X. You call the triangles Y. So you can just work this. X plus X plus X will give you 3X. And 3X equals 27 will give you 9. So we know that our X is 9. 3X equals 27. You divide both sides by 3, we get 9. So we put our 9 here, times Y, times Y, times Y. So we have 9Y cubed, which is equal to what, 72. Divide both sides by 9, you are going to get 8. So Y cubed equals 8. And the third root of 8 is 2. So we know that the rectangle is 2. And then the triangle is 9. So 2 times 9 is giving us 18. So answer is C. We have another question here. A taxi charges 20 cedis for a hire up to 10 kilometers ride. It charges 5 cedis for every other kilometer. The first 10 kilometers, the customer will pay 20 cedis. So now the customer has to pay for the 12. Now for all the 12, the customer is going to pay what? For each, the customer is going to pay 5 cedis. So 5 times the 12 will give you 60. So 60 cedis for the remaining 12 kilometers. So adding everything, you're going to have 80 cedis, which is D. Each of the following linear inequalities has its solution represented on a number line. So with this one, I always get the answer by looking at the direction of the arrow. And see the direction of the arrow, just draw the sign like that. And if this part is shaded, you're equal to below. And put your variable on your left, and then the number that you have down here on your right. So the answer to this question is D. Question 40. The school has a budget of 240 cedis per class to buy drinks. A sachet costs 10 cedis. So sachet, 10 cedis. Then bottle costs what? 12 cedis. It says if you want to buy 12 sachets, drink. So the sachet times 12, you are getting what? 120. So that's what it's going to cost out of the budget. Now, if it's a budget, we actually don't want to spend above the budget. So our sign here will be less than or equal to. If you want to buy 12 sachet drink, what is the maximum number of bottle drinks you can buy? A bottle drink costs 12 cedis. If a bottle drink costs 12 cedis and you have 120 cedis and you don't want to exceed your budget, you're going to end up buying 10. But based on the question, so your bottle drink will be less than or equal to 10. So B is less than or equal to 10. So answer is A. Question 41. Take a look at the picture. Okay. So if you don't get the idea of plane geometry, you'll not be able to answer this. So this is angle on a straight line. 135 covering a part of it. So 180 minus 135 is going to give us. So it's giving us 45 degrees. So answer is A. 42. The painted lines parking spaces are parallel. The measure of angle 1 is 60 degrees. What's the measure of angle 2? Now, this also has to do with plane geometry. And looking at it, it's talking about parallel lines. And the angle at 1 corresponds to the angle at 2. So if angle 1 is 60 degrees, angle 2 is also 60 degrees. So answer is A. We also have another question on angles again. If a traffic light is placed at angle 4 on road A, what angle should a traffic light be placed on road B at the same angle? Or to give you the same angle, you have to place it at 8. So the answer to this one is D. So what's the value of angle B in the picture? 70 degrees here, 40 degrees here, and we don't know for this, but this is giving us a triangle. Internal angle of a triangle gives us 180 degrees. Now, this doesn't really matter if we are looking for an angle. So 70 plus 40 is 110. 110 plus 70 is giving us 180. So B is 70 degrees. So the answer to this is B. We have an octagon here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are supposed to find the internal angle of this octagon. Now, the formula is N minus 2 times 180 over N. Formula for finding the interior angle of a polygon. So N over here is 8. 8 minus 2 is 6. 6 times 180 is 1080. So divided by 8, you end up with 135. So answer is C. The next question, the garden shown in the picture has all its sides equal. What's the total distance around the garden without the gate? The perimeter of this whole garden will be 20. How did I get the 24 multiplied by L, which is perimeter for a square? So you have 20. Without the gate, the dimension for the gate is 2 meters, so minus 2. We're going to end up with 18. So the answer to this question is C. The next question. If the bearing from Mrs. Anto's house to the community hospital is 100 degrees, what's the bearing from the community hospital to Mrs. Anto's house?
So to begin, we draw our four cardinal points.
So this gives us 90. So we have an extra 10. If this is 100, we have an extra 10. And this angle, which is 10 degrees, will alternate with this angle, which is also 10 degrees. So if this angle alternates with this angle, we have 10 degrees here. And from this point is 90, 180, 270. So 270 plus the extra 10 is giving us what? 280 degrees. So answer is C. Find the magnitude of the vector. This. V equals square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared. So we are going to end up with 9 plus 16, which is 25. So square root of 25 is giving us what? 5. So answer is A. The next one. If the square of the hypotenuse is 169, which square number is 169? It's 13. And this is the hypotenuse, the longest side. And the square of the opposite. If this is my angle, this is my opposite. Square of my opposite is 144, which will be 12. So I'm supposed to find the adjacent. And according to Pythagoras' theorem, the 13 squared will be equal to 12 squared plus A squared. So you have your 169 here minus, you're going to move here, so you have 144 equals A squared. So 169 minus, you're going to end up with 25. So you're going to find the square root of this 25 and you're going to end up with 5. So this is also A. She too is buying a new television. She finds a television with a screen of 41 inch diagonal and length of 41 inches. What's the height of the television screen? So this is also going to be 41 squared equals 40 squared plus h squared. So we're going to have 41 squared minus 40 squared equals h squared. Now when you follow the same procedure, find the square root of what you get here, you're going to end up with 81, square root of 81. The answer is going to be 9, so 9 inches. That's the answer, so A. There's another question on trigonometry. It says the angle of a stone from the top of a tower is, on the ground is 45 degrees. So this is the angle of depression moving down. If the stone is 120 meters away from the tower, find the height. So with this, you have your angle here. You have your adjacent and you need your opposite. So tan is the best to use. So tan of the angle, which is 45, equals toa, opposite, which is what we don't know. So A over adjacent, which is 120. So 1 equals A over 120. So to get your A, cross multiply 1 times 120 is 120. So the answer to this is C, 120 meters. Now, question 52. A equals 3 negative 2. So this being your what you're supposed to substitute into. So you have 2 multiplied by 3 negative 2 minus your B, which is 1, 2, plus C, which is 5, 5. So 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times negative 2 is negative 4, minus 1 plus 5, minus 2 plus 5. So 6 minus 1 is 5, 5 plus 5 is 10. So 10 for the top, minus 4 minus 2 is minus 6, minus 6 plus 5 is minus 1. So 10 negative 1. So answer to this question is B. Vectors A equals xi plus 14j and b equals 3i minus 7yj are equal vectors. So let's equate them. So this equals this and this equals that. So let's start with the x. Xi equals 3i. So if they are equal, I cancels I, x is 3. So we know x is 3. Now for y, 14j equals minus 7yj. So j cancels j. Minus 7 over minus 7. So you have minus 2. 7 here, 1, 7 here, 2. So minus 2. So answer to this is B. The next one, calculate the surface area of the shape below. This is a cube. And the surface area of a cube is 6L squared. 6. Then your L is your length, which is 5. 5 squared is 25. 25 times 6. So that's giving us 150. So answer to this is D.
So this question, we're going to use the scale factor for the expansion of the lower part to get this side. So to get the scale factor for the lower side, we are going to... So to get it done, 7.5 over 3 equals... So this is the longest part. So which corresponds to what you have at the top here. So h over the smallest, which is 1.8. So we are going to cross multiply and we are going to have 13.5 equals 3h. When we divide both sides by 3, we are going to have 4.5. So answer is B. So the next question, a class teacher has asked her learners to investigate the knowledge that community members have about cholera. Which of the data collection methods will be appropriate? So internet, observation, interview, and then database. So if they want to have the knowledge about the people, knowledge is in their head. You only have to ask them. So by interview, see. The next one is an infographic which shows the percentage of work done by various sections of a school. Now, this is the work done by the various sections out of 100%. It says, what is the average percentage of the work done by the 5 sections? So each section had these marks. So the average means the mean. So you add everything and then divide by the number of sections, which is 5. When you add everything, you are going to end up with 270. 270 divided by 5 is 54. So answer is C. So a cocoa farmer made a table for the sale of her cocoa products for the year 2023 on a quarterly basis. So this is what she has. January to March 29, April to June 18, July to September 42, and then October to December 31. So when you find the sum of this, you are going to have 120. Now 120, to find the average, 120 over 4. So it's actually in quarters, so we have 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 quarters in 12. So 120 over 4 is giving us 30. So answer to this is B. So with this question, it says the graph shows the number of goals scored in 4 different games by a team. How many goals do they need to score in their 5th match to raise their average to 4 goals per match? We've actually been given the mean, which is 4. And we've been told that
they actually played 4 matches and they need a 5th match to raise their average to 4. So for the first match, we know they scored 1. The second match, they scored 5. The third match, they scored 4. The fourth match, they scored 2. Plus the 5th match, you don't know X. So to work this out, you add everything for this. You're going to get 12 plus X over 5 equals 4. So when you work everything out very well, you're going to have 12 plus X equal to 20. Make X the subject, you're going to get 8. So the answer to this question is D. The last question. Kofi has some red balls and some blue balls in a bag. Altogether, he has 36 balls. Kofi picks 1 ball from the bag. The probability that Kofi picks a red ball is X. The probability that he picks a blue ball is 5X. Work out how many blue balls are in the bag. So let A represent the number of red balls and B represent the number of blue balls. So we are told that the total number of balls are 36. So R plus B, 36. And we know that the probability of picking a red ball is X. The probability of picking a blue ball is 5X. So X plus 5X. You are picking balls which are red and blue from a bag. So they're both probabilities should add up to 1. So that's what we have here. So going through, we add a 5X to the X, we have 6X. 6X equals 1. We can find X, which will give us the probability of picking a red ball. So the probability of picking a red ball is 1 over 6. Probability of picking a blue ball, we just have to substitute 1 over 6 into 5X. So we get 5 over 6. So probability of picking a blue ball is 5 over 6. The probability of picking a red ball can be expressed in a ratio. So 36R equals 1 over 6. So the probability equals, probability of picking a red ball equals number of red balls over the total. So over here, we know the probability. The probability is 1 over 6 equals number of red balls from what you've done. S, number of red balls is what you don't know. So R over the total number of balls, which is what? 36. Now, once you grab this, you know what is happening over here. The probability of getting a red ball is 1 over 6 equals number of red balls over total number of balls. So when you do your cross multiplication, you're going to have 6R equals 36. So that's where the 6 is coming from. So number of balls, number of red balls are 6. We know number of red balls. We know the total number of balls. We just have to find the difference. So number of blue balls is 30. Question 1. Write 2,748,595. Correct to the nearest 10,000. Now you can pause the video and answer them before I answer. And the answer to question 1 is C. Question 2. Find the product of 0.0409 and 0.0021, leaving the answer in standard form. And the answer to question 2 is B. Question 3. A student spent 1 over 4 of their money on books and 1 over 3 on transport. What fraction of the money was left? And the answer to question 3 is B. Given that P equals BDEF and Q equals AEFG are subsets of the universal set ABCDEFG, find P union Q. Question 4, the answer is B. 5. Convert 3 whole number 1 over 5 to a decimal fraction. Answer to question 5 is D. Now, in the diagram, angle PMN equals 60 degrees, MP equals 6 centimeters. Take tan 60 equals root 3. Find the length of NP. The answer to question 6 is A. 7. Root 2 plus root 3 plus root 8 plus root 27. The answer to question 27 is A. 8. Which of the following inequalities represent the shaded region in the diagram? The answer to question 8 is A. 9. Given the vector m equals 3, 1, n equals negative 4, 1, evaluate 2m minus n. The answer to question 9 is B. Question 10. A fair die and a fair coin are rolled together once. Find the probability of obtaining a head and an even number. Question 10 is A.